Hey, welcome back to the channel. Yes, I've been busy. A couple days ago, I was able to get out here to the garage and get a little bit of work done on this Manco. See, I taken the old motor off, which was this motor here, which is a Power Sports Tecumseh, 5.5 horsepower. Looks like Briggs and Stratton, but it says Tecumseh and it says Briggs and Stratton. I'm going with Tecumseh because of the carburetor setup and the overhead valve and everything. I'm going with Tecumseh. Runs good. I just didn't have a good carburetor setup for it. And I wanted some immediate reliability. So I went ahead and opened up the box on this Hemi. Oh yeah, Hemi 212 Predator here. I put this on a few days ago and run a throttle cable up the front here. But yeah, see, she broke. So I went and bought the factory throttle cable for a Manco go-kart. That way it'll fit right here inside this mounting bracket right here like it's supposed to. And it'll hook up really good right up here. And so I've been waiting a couple days on that, and that's finally came in the mail. You know, everything comes from eBay or Amazon, usually, you know, or could we not say that? The Jungle website and Fleabay. Pardon me, I've been, yeah, just getting over a cold too. But that's where we're at so far. I gotta run to the house, get the parts, and come out here and see if I can't get my girlfriend to record putting a few of these parts on for you. That could be fun. It's just gonna be boring because it's gonna be quiet. I don't know the whole rules with, you know, playing music in the background and whatnot. So if y'all could leave me some comments, let me know anything about that, that'd be helpful. But yeah, that's where we're at. Tonight, I am going to put on a new throttle cable from there down to there. And I already got the brakes good enough. They stop. Boy, are they rattly. Maybe somebody can tell me about that. I was looking them up. And this is what we got down here. We got this thing here, but it's rattling all over the place. And so, this one's permanent setup. And I've seen the ones that just bolt in. And I'm wondering if I shouldn't just weld a plate there and buy one of them new bolt-in ones and use that bolt-in one. But I don't know, because this one's, it's reliable. It just rattles all over the place. Maybe if I put some grease in there, it won't make no noise. But anyway, I'm gonna get to that and I'll see you then. All right, so I've been on it. All right, this is what we got done. See, we got... Put that down. Okay, look. We got the throttle cable here hooked up with enough travel that I can take the gas pedal here, run it all the way down to the gas pedal bottoms out, without overstretching the cable. I didn't have that before. I overstretched the cable and snapped it out of the ring. Now I gotta put it back in, but it would have sucked to keep doing that over and over again. And this one here is made for it. So it's got the swivel. That's kind of cool. I like that. When you're rocking a, you know, the old gas pedal there, you know, she swivels on there with it. So, got that done. And I'm like, ugh. I didn't want to have to build any brackets or anything for to make my gas tank fit. So, this is what I did. Matter of fact, I'm working on installation right now. All right. You see this here? It's known as a whack-em stick. Also known as a hammer. Yep. I took this here hammer and I altered that there gas tank. That doesn't look that bad, you know. It's not going to hurt anything. And I made sure I didn't put any holes in it or anything. I just altered the metal a little bit. So let me take that here. And so you got to line up these two screws in these here two holes. And I'm trying to do it one-handed. But she fits. Original gas tank. Clearance for the seat. So I thought it was pretty rad. Actually, a clearance for the seat. So I beat her into shape. So that means I have gas. Gas pedal. Brake pedal, brakes, four tires, and a steering wheel. I just need to get the seat on now. So I'm going to get working on that. And I'll be back to you when I get that done. Oh, yeah. All right. Thanks for holding out with me. I got the seat done. Yeah, look at her. She's nice and soft. Yeah, she's soft. She ain't going to hurt my tailbone. This is how we did it. I'm going to toss a little knife down there. And I chopped up, I went and I bought this from the old jungle website. This is a yoga mat foam thing. It's a lot thicker than, you know, anything I could find when I was out at the stores. I could find thin stuff, but nothing with that wrestling mat texture that I was looking for. And that's as close as I could find. So what we did was, I doubled it up on the bottom here, and I singled it on the back, and I stuck it to the wood with Loctite, because I figure I'm not going to be taking the bottom seat off, and the back seat I can get to the bolts from the back, and I'm sure I'll be able to feel through that stuff if I need to find them, drill holes to get to them, or cut a square to get to them, so I think it'll work out just fine. You know, she's pretty good. I took her for a rip out in the yard. Oh, yeah. That brake is chattering really bad. But I hope it cleans up because, you know, it was pretty rusty. And it's running over them brake pads with that rusty rotor. You know, it's like leaving your car sit for 2 weeks and hitting the brakes. You're like... So we'll see if them come back around. If they don't come back around, we'll pick up some new brakes. And I was doing donuts in the front yard, and the dang thing, she shut off on me because of the oil shutoff valve, or oil shutoff line, which is, if you look up in there, you see that yellow wire right there, goes into the block. Yeah, when its oil swishes from side to side, it thinks the motor tipped over, and it grounds out the spark and shuts the motor down, so... I have to figure out how to not let it do that. And so I'm going to look that up when I go inside. But I consider her done. She's a running, driving go-kart now. It runs, it stops, it does donuts, passes my test. So here she is in all her glory, you know. A Manco with no roll cage. You know, it's balloon rear tires. You know, micro shocks in the front hubs. You know, two-wheel peel. Really fun for doing donuts. But yeah, here she is in all her glory. And, you know, I appreciate all y'all are watching the builds. And I hope I'll see you on the next video. Take it easy.